Hello from the National Weather Service offices in Billings, Glasgow, Great Falls, and Missoula, Montana. This presentation is a breakdown of our winter weather terminology, which many of you may or may not be familiar with. By the end of this presentation, you should have a greater understanding of how we issue winter weather-related products and what these products mean to you. Let's begin with our winter weather advisories. When we are considering issuing this product, we are concerned with winter weather that will be bad enough that it won't necessarily cause cancellation of plans, but will cause the need for adjustment to those plans. For example, the most obvious type of weather will be light snow accumulations that occur on previously dry road surfaces. This first picture on the left plainly shows a dry road surface unaffected by snow. In the second picture on the right, it shows the very same stretch of road just 5 minutes after the previous photo was taken. You'll notice that the visibility lowered dramatically, and the road surface is beginning to become slick from light snow cover. This type of quick change is what we consider for a winter weather advisory. Deteriorating visibilities are also considered, which they can be due to snow, blowing snow, or fog. In the example pictured here, it is because of snow. Also, wet or slushy roadways that quickly freeze, let's say overnight after the temperatures drop below freezing. If the roads have changed for the worse from the night before, that warrants an advisory. Winter storm warnings take into consideration dangerous weather with high impacts that will likely cause cancellations and closings, such as schools, sporting events, workplaces, roads and highways, mountain passes, etc. Warnings may be issued for the following: any long-duration heavy snow event, short-duration heavy snow events impacting main travel corridors or urban areas, and also strong winds with snow causing poor visibilities and large drifts of snow. This is important to note. Impacts are not dictated solely by the weather. Location also plays a large role as well. For example, 4 inches of snow in an urban area may have more of an impact than 10 inches of snow in a much higher terrain. Again, this stresses that while 4 inches is less snow than 10 inches, it has a much greater impact to the public. Here are another 3 examples of when winter storm warnings may be issued. If snow falls when trees are in bloom and vegetation is lush, most commonly in the spring and autumn seasons, wet, heavy snow can cause loading of trees. When this happens, trees can easily break, causing structural damage, as well as bringing down power lines, causing power outages. More commonly, any type of very heavy snow or large accumulations of snow during the winter months can cause many impacts to the public. Also, blowing and drifting of snow, which causes low visibilities, especially over roadways, are definitely perfect for winter storm warnings. Blizzard warnings are very specific in that they are issued for strong winds combined with snow, causing whiteout conditions that last for a prolonged period of time. Blizzards are very high impact events and cause widespread closures of roads, businesses, schools, etc. Freezing rain advisories and ice storm warnings are more rare events for Montana, with ice storms being much more rare than freezing rain events. While they are both possible, the typical ice storms that happen most often are widely known for occurring on the east coast of the United States. Freezing rain events are much more common, and advisories are issued when there is a light accumulation or a thin glaze of rain that freezes on road surfaces. This can cause dangerous travel conditions. Ice storm warnings are actually for ice of a significant accumulation, which can cause widespread power outages, down trees, down power lines, as well as structural damage. Wind chill advisories and warnings are very common across Montana and can be some of the most dangerous winter weather that we have. Very cold temperatures that combine with wind can produce extremely dangerous conditions. Exposed skin is susceptible to frostbite, and hypothermia can very quickly set in if precautions are not taken. Here is a chart that depicts winds and temperature combinations and how quickly one can experience frostbite if skin is not protected. Depending on the severity and duration of winds and cold temperatures, will determine whether a wind chill advisory or a wind chill warning is issued. That sums up our winter weather terminology here at the National Weather Service. Be sure to check us out on the web or by looking us up on Facebook or Twitter. Each National Weather Service office has its own page, so be sure to follow your local office for the latest weather updates. Thank you!